just is. On behalf of your loyal subject, I congratulate you on the birth of the Princess Kindra.
Thank you, my good man.
Oh. 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 Your Majesties, in all my many years, I don't think I've ever seen such a beautiful child.
Your Majesties, I announce Prince Birion of the Enchanted Forest and his entourage of knights.
Ta-da! Ta-da!
Prince Birion, it's an honor to welcome you. Far too long a time has passed since we last saw you.
Welcome, Prince Birion.
Nothing could have kept me away on this auspicious occasion. Please accept the humble gift we have brought to celebrate the birth of Princess Kindra.
Oh, no! Not now! Quit that, you little fools! This is no time for your silly antics! You have to observe fairy protocol! You'll have years to play with her!
As I was saying, we have brought some trifling gifts, Your Majesties. We hope you and the enchanting little tadpole princess will like them.
Thank you, Prince Birion. We will long remember your gracious generosity.
Your Majesties, my knights and I are most impatient to see her. May we?
My dear?
Yes, of course.
Behave yourselves!
Let them play together, Sir Sean. This is not the moment for court etiquette.
Not to mention, Sean, you've been with her for a while and we haven't even seen her.
Your Majesty! The five cavaliers!
Ah, honored cavaliers, it is a great privilege to welcome you to the castle.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
But there are only four of you. Where is the Cavalier of the Light?
He's late as usual, Your Majesty, but he'll be here soon.
It's a good thing he's so fast.
I'm sure he had something important to do. You all have such a sense of duty.
What you tactfully neglected to mention, sire, is that our brother has no sense of time.
We'll start without him.
Exactly.
My dear, the little princess.
Right away.
Adorable little Princess Kindra, here is my gift to you. You shall have the power of warming the hearts of all those who are near you.
The goodness that lies within your heart will flood out of you like water and touch even the most hard-hearted.
Princess, my gift to you is a spirit as fresh and lively as mountain air.
Princess Kindra, you shall have all the beauty of my element, the earth. You'll be as lovely as a snow-capped mountain and as graceful as a field of wheat.
Stand aside, worm.
No, Countess Maya, please. You may not enter without being announced first. This is court protocol. Please, Countess.
Stand aside, I said.
No, stop, please, all of you. Today is a day of joy and happiness. What an unexpected pleasure to see you here today.
Unexpected? Yes, I dare say, since you did not see fit to invite me to this august gathering. But I was simply dying to see the beautiful little princess. You must grant me that privilege. Oh, she's simply adorable.
Majesties, I humbly beg your pardon for my late arrival.
You'd have been too late in any case, even if you'd arrived with your brothers.
Why, Countess, what a way to speak!
Be silent, Cavalier of the Light, or I will extinguish your glow forever! I hope you've enjoyed this little party, because now it's over! I cast a spell before I entered the castle, and I am invulnerable to any kind of attack. The spell will last just long enough for me to give little Kindra my gift. She will live 15 happy years, but on her 16th birthday, she will be pricked by a spinning wheel needle and fall into a sleep from which she will never awaken, and with her, the entire population of the kingdom! That will be the signal that we, the powers of the evil shadows, have been waiting for. And from that day on, we will be the masters of the entire world!
Is there anything we can do?
Very little, I'm afraid, Sir Sean. That evil witch has launched her curse.
Prince Birion, don't speak that way, as if all were lost.
Well, we ain't exactly winning. Can you undo Maya's curse?
I told you on other occasions never to despair where the forces of evil are concerned.
But the curse is already in place, definitive and final.
Her curse is nothing more than a simple prediction, and therefore subject to change. Your Majesty, don't take it to heart. I cannot completely annul Maya's prediction, but I do believe there are certain things I can do to make it less terrible. The important thing is to present a united front against the forces of evil, Your Majesty.
Right.
As long as the good have courage, evil will never triumph.
We're Witcher, Cavalier. Count on us to do anything it takes to foil the plans of the forces of evil!
Let's keep our voices down, friends. We don't want to disturb the princess.
Oh, yes, yes, of course. Shh.
I will now give the princess my gift, Your Majesty. May I?
Of course, Cavalier.
Come here, my little beauty. Your Royal Highness Princess Kindra, I hereby declare this variation on the fate assigned to you. You will sleep long, but not forever. The forces of evil will be vanquished, and your beautiful blue eyes will open after your 16th birthday to behold the star-studded sky once again. You will be awakened by a handsome prince who will come from a far-off land. When he sees your sleeping form, he will be so moved by your beauty that he will be unable to resist kissing you. Then you will arise, and together you will walk the world. And the very moment that his lips brush against your alabaster skin, the entire world will be saved from evil.
Captain Kingsler reporting, sir.
What news do you bring me, Captain?
I just spoke to the Whale Scouts, sir, and they report absolutely no suspicious activity at the border.
Excellent.
They're on guard around the clock, sir.
Very good, Klingsor. Thank you. The most important families from every town in Snowland are coming here.
It's quite a turnout, and they're all bringing rich gifts for Prince Rackle's birthday. It would not be a good time for the evil beings of the Aurora Borealis to make an appearance.
So kind as to go and inquire as to whether the young prince is ready?
At once, Your Majesty.
You'll never find me.
Your Royal Highness, I have your hat here. Your Royal Highness, you must put on your hat. I beg you.
His Majesty wishes to know if the young prince is ready.
He's ready except for his hat. I can't find him.
Well, find him, for heaven's sake. The procession of nobles is entering the throne room.
You shouldn't get poor old Varan all flustered and worked up, Rackle. You know he starts to stutter, and he has a whole bunch of nobles to announce today.
Cordell, what a surprise. You know, I didn't think I'd see you today.
How could I stay away? It's my pal's birthday.
Well, I guess we better go to the throne room. Now that you're here, I can put in my appearance.
Well, you know, I'm not exactly crazy about crowds. But for your sake, I'll come in and I'll watch from a distance.
Huh? Thanks, Cordell. Life would be such a drag without you. Don't leave me ever.
You'd better get going, my boy. I'll see you later.
I suppose so.
Your Majesty, all is prepared.
Goodbye.
Majesty, the city of Icetown sends its sincerest best wishes to Prince Rackle on his birthday.
Thank you kindly, Mr. Mayor. The Duke and Duchess of Steinberg! I mean the Duke and Duchess of Bergstein!
Your Majesty, the Duchy of Bergstein sends this trifling gift on the occasion of your son's birthday.
Thank you so much, dear Duchess. You do us too much honor.
See what's going on, Klingsor.
At once, sir.
My land.
Sir.
Yes.
Xanatos' winged hordes are attacking from the sky, even as we speak.
Thank you.
is all that noise going on outside the palace walls?
Obviously, the townsfolk celebrating.
Rackle!
Aha! What very impressive gifts! We too have brought a gift for little Prince Rackham, and after ours he will wish for no other, because our gift to him is none other than death!
Your Majesties, unfortunately, I lack the power to undo the curse completely, but there are certain parts of it that I can transform.
Oh, please! Yes!
Rackle will assume the adult form he would have had if he had grown normally when he awakens the sleeping princess with a kiss. And throughout his life, my brothers and I will watch over him and protect him from harm. This I swear.